Hello everyone, I am Mohammad Afifuddin. In this video, we will see the design procedure of short column. So in this types of problem, they will give the data like factored load, that is PU, or they can give the grade of concrete and steel. Okay. So here is the procedure. First of all, we have to assume the suitable percentage of steel, that is ASC, and it can be taken between the 0.8% to the 4% of gross area. Then our second step is to find out the area of concrete, that is AC, and we have to determine the area of concrete in terms of AG. AG is gross area. So that to find out the area of concrete in terms of AG, we have to deduct the area of steel from the gross area so that we can get the area of concrete. Okay, but until this step, we don't know the value of area of steel as well as area of concrete. Okay, so here we are taking the unknown, and in third step, that is the gross area, we will use the formula which is given in IS code on clause number 39.3 of page number 71, that is PU is equal to 0.4 FCK into AC plus 0.67 FY into ASC. And from this formula, by equating, putting all the value and putting AG, that is gross area, unknown, we can find out the value of AG, that is gross area. And after that, we will find out the dimensions of columns. And we know that for square columns, one side is equal to under root of gross area. That means gross area is equal to side square. And for rectangular column, firstly we have to assume the width of the section. And from that, we know the area of rectangular column is equal to width into depth. So width we are assuming, and from that we can calculate the depth of column. Then after that, we will calculate the area of reinforcement, and after finding the area of reinforcement, we will assume suitable diameter of bar, and we will calculate the number of bars required in columns. And after that, our last step will be to design the lateral ties. Okay, and in the lateral ties, the diameter of lateral ties should not be less than 1.4 times of diameter or 6 mm, whichever is more. Okay, here note that if the length of column is given, then calculate the effective length on the basis of table number 28 of IS 456-2000, and then check for slenderness ratio and minimum eccentricity as L effective by B is less than 12. Okay, then calculate the minimum eccentricity as E minimum is equal to L upon 500 plus D by 30, which is should be greater than or equal to 20 mm, and E minimum by D should be less than 0.05 on an axially loaded column. Okay, and you will get the clear idea when we will take the problems. So this was the procedure of design of short axially loaded column. Thank you.